All right. Do you want me to take this?
No, whatever you like. Okay. I've got stuff on. Okay. So, Sue, we're still here at the Toronto Screenwriters Conference. You've made notes. I have made notes. As a matter of fact, during Glenn Mazzara's talk, I came up with an idea for a whole new television series.
Great.
True story.
Yeah. I love Glenn.
And during your chat, I started making some serious story notes.
Good.
So we are chatting with Jen Grisanti.
Yay.
Who's like...
Very happy to be here.
Well, there's that, but you're like story consultant extraordinaire, basically.
Thank you.
I mean, it was a packed chat for you.
Yes.
It's so funny because you never have any idea what to expect. When you're going to go into a room, you sit there. I certainly know the TV pilot does draw a lot of people, but you never know at these type of events.
Yeah.
You know, you just don't. So it was a very nice.
I loved the group.
I was very happy.
Because, I mean, you know, we did Glenn's chat, and his chat was full. We did Emily's chat, and hers was full, but yours was just, it was, people were sitting on the floor.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
So, I mean.
It was cool, too, because right before you came in, or got started at least, I put on Twitter, I was like, oh, Mind Reels and I are excited to learn from Jen Grisanti. And I tagged a TSC in it as well.
Right.
And all the hashtags and stuff. But, like, immediately they're like, us too, enjoy!
That's awesome. Well, I love being in Toronto. I'm very, very happy to be here.
Everybody loves Toronto.
Thrilled to be a part of this conference that is mind-blowing.
Yeah, it's
mind-blowing.
Great.
Yeah, every year it gets better and better.
To have, like, a room that full of people who really want to learn.
Yeah, they want to be there.
Feel that in their energy. Yeah. Like, there's nothing better.
No. It's like going to university but wanting to be there.
Yeah.
Well, you go the other way sometimes, too, because then there's people who are like, I'm already God's gift to writing, and I don't really have anything to learn from her, so maybe I can teach her a thing or two.
Right.
But there's always, like, a different
dynamic
if they're there just because they want to absorb as much as possible.
I found, like, I agree that in every crowd, you usually have a few people who are going to challenge the system, and today, I mean, it was, they were just there to absorb.
Yeah.
And I felt like every question, every contribution was all about the material. So it's like that's nothing excites me more than to feel the transformation happening. And even though it might be foreign, some of the terms might be foreign to people, to have them be open enough to try, to try something new.
Now, you started doing this in 2008.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just, see, I was
did.
Totally paying attention, took notes.
I love it.
And it's just, it boggles the mind.
I mean,
I would be there listening to people trying to help them, sure, but then I'm like, that could be a really good story idea for me.
Right.
Does that happen?
Oh, yeah. Like, I think, this is what I know, because I attend conferences, I mean, when I started my whole business, I was going to conferences non-end. Because, and the gift that I found is I came up with all my best ideas. When I was listening to other people share, it was like all of a sudden the floodgates opened. And that is everything that we want from the teaching perspective, to open those floodgates.
Oh, totally.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just because it's not that I don't get ideas everywhere else, but I think it's maybe it's just there's so much.
This weekend, every year.
Like every year, we've been here, this is our fourth year, I think.
Oh, great.
And every year we come in with the intention of, okay, this year we're going to cover this, we'll write about so-and-so, we'll do this. Halfway through the Screenwriters Conference, every time we're like, I'm making notes for myself.
Right.
It's not worried about the blog, I'm writing notes for me.
Yep, and, I love that. I love that. Well, and I also think, like, and I say, that's why I say to people, I'm going to give you a link that has the clip notes.
Mm-hmm.
So, because really what I like people to write is ideas on their story.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Like, I would prefer that their brainstorming is going on as a result of what I'm teaching, but they're applying it to their story.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll get the clip notes.
Yeah, and
so,
then you can go back and touch it up if you're
Yeah.
Which is great.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was so quiet in there because everybody was writing and typing stuff. Like, everybody was just like...
Everybody's being like... students. And
yeah.
Like, I haven't seen this since grade two.
I love that.
I think that's the thing with this whole conference is it gives everybody a chance to not only get together and network, but to talk about writing. It's just the act of writing.
Yeah.
And
even
that process just sort of kind of gets your juices flowing a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I love that, like, when I would ask the questions, like, has anybody ever been divorced or lost a job? And so many people were willing to raise their hand. Yeah. I was
has
very
anybody had their heart broken?
I know. The whole
the
world
girls
in front
of us. How many hands do I
like,
put up?
Yeah, I know. The girls in front of us were like, five times!
I know.
I feel really bad about
our
that.
Our universal life moments that we all have to move through and get to the other side of. Yep.
But, I mean, that's where our best writing comes
it
from,
is.
Too, right?
That's our goal.
Write what you know.
Yeah, write what you know. Write, and I think write from a place of emotional truth. I mean, the hope is that you're going to add fiction to the emotional truth, but you're going to come from an authentic place.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which a lot of people have trouble getting to in the first place. Because we're so busy creating the fiction.
The hard part about the writing what you know is when people get too stuck, well, that's not how it happened.
Right.
The story didn't unfold that way. And so, well, you have to recognize that for a TV platform or a screenwriting platform, you have to add fiction.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
That's awesome.
And you have to be able to see your own story from someone else's point of view.
Yes.
That's also in it,
too.
Yeah.
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 It's all about worldview.
Yeah.
It is.
That's where I get hung up.
It'd be great if everyone else was a villain.
Yeah. That's so true.
And that was easy to pick out. But then you look like an idiot because you're the only one who didn't know they were evil.
You're totally right. I agree. I agree.
And, of course, you came up working with Spelling and working with CBS Paramount. I mean, it's not like you just decided.
And NBC. Right now. I've been with NBC for 8 years.
Writers on the Verge.
Yep.
Yeah. See, I totally paid attention.
Yes, you do!
He doesn't even have his notes out right now.
No, but it's just amazing. So it's not like one day you just woke up and said, I'm going to do this. You've got the history to prove that you can do it.
Thank you.
So it was kind of like a master class watching you saying this. These are the steps. And I love the fact that you used examples that even if you don't understand the terms you're using, you're using examples that people can relate to, like using Homeland
and
Mr. Robot. And,
so and it's reinforcing. It's all about using the same shows for going through the whole system so that people could really absorb. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, it's just...
And apply it to their own.
Right?
Because she's watched so many pilots.
Yes.
That's got to be rough.
It is. The fascinating thing is, like, I think, just like anything in life, like if you're reading 60 pilots, just like if you're working with 100 people a year, their story comes alive. And so you know within the first 10 pages, is this something I emotionally identify with, or is this outside my realm or interest? And so you know that. That's why I'm all about capture them with emotion at the beginning, and then you'll keep them.
Which is good because I moved the top of my act one to the top of my T's because I thought that would work better there. So
good.
Proved it right there.
Love it when you learn and then you apply.
Right?
Yep.
Doesn't happen often enough.
That's great.
Because this is only once a year.
Yeah,
so
that's what it is.
Only so much learning we could do. I even said, like, by lunch, my head was already so full.
I'm sure.
I got to get outside for a second.
I love it.
Now, you, of course, chatted with Glenn on your podcast.
Yes.
Is there any other writers out there that you want to chat with that you haven't had a chance? Or?
Well, it's interesting because my podcast, I have 65 that are up on iTunes. And the reason I stopped doing them like a year ago, and I actually am going to do a new one with Glenn this week on Damien. So, but the reason I stopped was just because I was so busy. And I felt like, all right, I have 65 up. People are going to draw from those. And then ISA, International Screenwriters Association, actually revamped and put the podcast on their website so that they were even fresher. Because the bottom line is, it's all, no matter when the podcast took place, it's valuable information.
Yeah, it's not
top
going
writers
to
in the business.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, I think, like, if there were writers that I would still want to interview. I mean, one writer, and I have no personal connection to him, was someone who was here, I think, last year, was Bo Willimon. So, you know, so I look at, there are certain people, but I think, like, and then meeting Moira here from Breaking Bad, like, I certainly would love to interview her in the future, and so I'm all about the type of writer like Glenn Mazzara who will dig deep into the good, the bad, and the ugly of what the writer's journey is.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, if they're looking for you, they can find you on Facebook under Jane.
Yes, they can find. Well, now, see, my personal page, I hit the limit of five, but the business page is great because there is no limit. So that's Jen Grisanti Consultancy. My LinkedIn is Jen Grisanti, and my Twitter is at Jen Grisanti.
Perfect.
And my website is jengrisanti.com.
That
all easy,
right? It's easier than mine.
And we'll link to your Twitter with this anyway.
Oh, totally.
Up,
so. Yeah. But Jen, that's fantastic. Thank you.
You've got it.
And
thank you.
Hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.
Oh God, we're I'm excited.
Yeah, I know. I gotta go home and empty my brain. I wish I could do like a down like. Just...